Hey guys, it's Dave here from Creative Path Films, and today's video is part two in our series on color rendering scores. Once again, featuring the outstanding Sekonic C-800. If you haven't seen part one, which covered spectrum, CRI, and TLCI, please follow the link down in the description and up here, as there's a lot of ground that we've already covered that'll help make sense of this video. In this video, we're going to cover TM-30 and SSI, and we'll be exploring how to use them to evaluate light sources. Once again, thank you so much to Sekonic and their Australian distributor KL for loaning us a C-800 and making this series possible. All right, let's get into part two. Next, we're going to have a look at TM-30, or Technical Memorandum 30. TM-30 is a more recent and much more reliable index for assessing a light's color accuracy. It is denoted by a label such as TM-30-18, with the last two digits indicating the year of the latest iteration. Instead of measuring 8, 15, or even 18 colors, TM-30 takes a sample of 99 different colors, curated from over 100,000 real-world color readings. Like CRI, TM-30 assumes human vision as the observer. It is considered the most reliable because the high number of color samples means that it's almost impossible to game by manufacturers. TM-30 will present two scores, RF and RG. RF is a score from 0 to 100, and the higher the number, the more color accurate the source. The RG score represents color saturation and has a range of 60 to 140. Anything that scores below 100 means colors are undersaturated, and anything over 100 means they are oversaturated. There's also a color vector graphic underneath the numerical scores, which shows a color wheel broken into 16 segments. The black line indicates the ideal target values, and the red line indicates the current measurement. Any points that track inside the circle indicate a hue that's undersaturated, and any points extending out from the circle indicate that they're oversaturated. Any arrows tracking sideways towards another point indicate the presence of a hue shift. Now let's have a look at some readings. We'll start with our tungsten source. As you probably guessed by this point, we have another set of virtually perfect scores. RF is maxed out at 100, and RG is also 100, meaning perfect color saturation. The color vector graphic indicates every point is hitting the mark except for segment 10, which has a slight hue shift. Now let's have a look at our Amaran 200X, first at 3400 Kelvin. As you can see, we have an RF score of 95 and an RG score of 102, indicating slight oversaturation. The color vector graphic indicates this slight oversaturation in certain quadrants. It also shows a desaturation in the yellows. The delta UV indicates a slight shift towards magenta. Now let's have a look at the same light, but this time set to 5600 Kelvin. In this color temperature, the light has scored slightly lower with an RF of 94, and the saturation remains the same at 102 RG. The delta UV has also flipped to a positive reading. Now let's recall our street lamp again, just for fun. As you can see here, the graph is all over the place. The RF score has plummeted to 42. And the RG and the color vector graphic indicate that the majority of the spectrum is undersaturated. Most of the colors are pulling aggressively towards the center, except for the yellow-orange at the top and some blues at the bottom. Both of these points are oversaturated and pulling in the hues either side of them. This kind of makes sense considering how narrow the spectrum was when we looked at the spectrum distribution graph and just how little color information there was for the majority of the wavelengths across the spectrum. There is definitely a push within the industry to make TM-30 the new standard for reporting the color accuracy of lights. Its broader range of color samples make it more applicable to the real world, as well as more transparent, as it's much harder for manufacturers to fudge their results. At the moment, most manufacturers are reporting CRI and maybe TLCI, but hopefully TM30 will become the dominant standard in the near future. As an aside, if you're wondering about the Delta UV scores and what they roughly equate to in the real world, a good rule of thumb is that plus or minus 0.004 is the approximate value of a 1/8 plus or minus green correction gel. Negative scores mean the light has a shift towards magenta, so will require plus green for the correction, whereas positive scores indicate a shift towards green, so a minus green gel or magenta gel will be required. The C800, of course, has a function that takes out all of the guesswork for you, and it's called filter mode. Once you open it up, make sure that you have the lighting filter option selected rather than the camera filter selection, and enter your target color temperature. You can now take a new reading or recall one from the memory. This page will present you with a ton of information. It will tell you the CCT value of your reading, the LBI, or light balancing index, which is the Myers shift adjustment that you'll need to make to achieve your target color temperature. The LBLF, which stands for light balancing lighting filter, is the option that will tell you which gel or combination of gels you'll need to make the desired correction. The C800 can display gels from the following ranges: Lee filters, Roscoe Cinegel, and Roscoe eColor Plus. Below that, we have the CCI, or Color Correction Index, which shows you the shift required in either green or magenta to match your target. Remember that a score with an M indicates that you need to add magenta, and a score with a G indicates that you need to add green. Then we have the CCLF, or Color Correction Lighting Filter, which will display the plus or minus green strengths required to compensate for any green magenta shift. If you see a line through either the LBLF or CCLF values, it means that there is no gel required or the shift is so small that no gels exist that are subtle enough to correct for the shift. The final index that we're going to explore is SSI, or Spectral Similarity Index. SSI is a tool used to compare the spectral qualities of two light sources against each other. The key difference with SSI is that it doesn't rely on an observer at all, instead doing a direct comparison of both lights' spectral distributions. SSI will take a sample measurement every 10 nanometer increment, called a bin measurement, along the spectrum between 380 and 670 nanometers. When judging SSI scores, a measurement of 70 to 80 is usable, 80 to 90 is good, and 90 to 100 is excellent. The SSI function in the C800 comes preloaded with a series of standardized light sources, such as the CIE D55 daylight standard and the 3200 Kelvin tungsten standard, as well as several more. These are the standards that lighting manufacturers use and aim to replicate when designing a fixture. You can also input a color temperature value and compare your light to an ideal reading for that CCT. Or you can recall a previous reading from the memory and compare two lights to each other to see how well they match. Let's start by dialing in our 3200 Kelvin tungsten standard and compare it to our Dido light. As you can see, the two don't perfectly align, and we have an SSI score of 89 out of 100. This is because the Dido light runs at a higher Kelvin value of 3400 to 3500 Kelvin. Now let's input a CCT of 3500 Kelvin to see how the two compare. As you can see, the graph is now much, much closer, and the light is scoring an SSI score of 100. Now let's have a look at our Amaran fixture at 3400 Kelvin color temperature to see how it graphs in comparison. As you can see, we have that same blue spike from the LED emitters, as well as a curve that tracks near the standard, but with some obvious variance. The light has scored an 82 for this test. Now let's have a look at this same light at 5,500 Kelvin and track it against the CIE D55 daylight standard. As you can see for this setup, we now have a score of 73, so lower than ideal. Note that this light is the original 200X and not the newer S model, which Amaran released later on with a focus on improving these SSI scores. You can also use SSI to compare two of your own light sources together. Let's take a reading of our Dido light once again. Now I'm going to recall the 200X at 3,400 Kelvin and overlay the two. Now you can see the two spectrums overlaid onto one another for comparison. And you can see that the 200X scores a 77 when compared to the Dido light. Now that we've explored each of the indexes used in the C800, there are two more functions that I want to quickly show you that are incredibly powerful. The first is the text function. Not only can you set a target value up the top of the page, but you can also display up to any 5 readings from across the various modes. Click on any of the boxes with a blue underline and you can customize the display. You can show CCT, luminance, delta UV, color correction, and filter information, as well as any of the index scores that we've explored so far. This is the page I use most frequently on the C800, as I can view most of the information I need all in one place. The other function I want to show you is the multi-lights mode. This enables you to directly compare up to 4 different light sources all in one place. You can go into option A, take a reading, then customize the first 3 starred values to change what's displayed on the main multi-lights page. You can then repeat this process for the other lights as well. If you select one or both of the filter options in your display and tap the small circular icon for any one of your lights, it will use that light as a target and display the gels needed to correct the other lights as closely as possible. A very useful feature. Well, that's it for our overview of the various light assessment indexes inside of the Sekonic C800. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it useful. And if you did, you can let me know by leaving it a thumbs up. And don't forget to leave a comment if you have any questions about the meter and how you can use it. Once again, I want to say a sincere thank you to Sekonic and KL for making this video possible. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you have an absolutely wonderful day, and we'll see you in the next video.